the capacity to recover quickly from difficulties or toughness, the ability to recover from or adjust to misfortune or change. These are the textbook definitions of resilience. And while these are indeed accurate, recently I heard a different version that I like even better. And that is resilience is the forward motion despite the absence of courage, comfort, and clarity. So whether you're only inching forward, at least you're moving forward. And this definition set me on an entire path of discovery about resilience that I want to share with you today. Welcome to Momentum Live. I'm Brooke Scott. So we are surrounded by resilience every day. And in my research, I read article after article of everyday people just facing and demonstrating resilience, you know, throughout medical diagnoses or trauma or loss. And, you know, of all of these things, you know, are considered difficult or considered tough times, certainly changing. And then, you know, a common theme throughout all of these stories that I read is that the protagonist was moving forward. They were always lacking comfort. They were always lacking that, you know, clarity and sometimes often courage, but still moving forward. So, you know, I think it's important that you understand people who are lacking resilience often feel overwhelmed and helpless. They feel like they must adapt unhealthy coping mechanisms like isolation or self-medication. But you know, research shows that resilience can be developed, that it can be strengthened over time, and that there are ways that if you change certain thought processes, change certain behaviors, that you can, you know, cultivate and build your resilience. So let's focus on a couple of those first, you know, right now. First, develop your self-awareness. It's incredibly important that you understand what causes your stress, how you respond, and you know, to how you respond to adversity. And understanding this will help you comprehend better your strengths and weaknesses. So building self-regulation skills, you know, this is important that we learn to remain focused on moving forward, even in times of stress. So learning some stress-reducing techniques is an incredibly important thing. Think about a time that you, even in just everyday life, when you've had to make a difficult phone call or you've had to do something difficult, a simple, you know, self-regulatory thing is to take a deep breath before you do it. So then again, learning coping skills. Coping skills are incredibly important. You know, things that like journaling or exercising, spending time outdoors, socializing with others, as well as, you know, leaning into your creative outlets, your hobbies, those things that make you feel good. Those are all coping skills. It's also important to increase optimism. You know, when you're feeling optimistic, you feel that you are more in control of the outcomes and things that you're experiencing in life. You focus on what you can do and the things you can do to take a step forward. Strengthening connections. You know, your support system plays a vital role in building resilience. Having those, you know, the family, the friends, and the community surrounding you and working on strengthening those connections will help you weather many, many storms. And then last but not least, know your strengths. You know, when you are facing some type of adversity, feeling capable and confident in knowing your strengths and your talents will help you push through, you know, that adversarial time or that challenge or toughness that you're going through. You know, resilience, like I said in the beginning, is forward motion in spite of a lack of courage, comfort, and clarity. So it's something we can develop and strengthen, but not only in times of challenge, but in just everyday life, everyday encounters with stress or any type of adversity, practicing this will help you build your resilience for those maybe bigger, more difficult moments. So a closing quote for you from Dr. Admit Sood said, "Resilience is the core strength you use to lift the load of life." I hope you guys have a great Monday and a great week, and I'll see you guys next week.